Oh, there we go.
There's some serious fish out here.
You can't keep up. You need more hands, boy.
Oh, this is brilliant. This is everything a bloke wants, isn't it? Like guns, fishing, food.
Yeah, boy!
The far north of New Zealand has miles of remote coastline. Most of it well away from the densely populated cities and towns, and often boat ramps are miles away. The fishing in these areas can be spectacular. The trouble is accessing it. Even if you can get there in a boat, the shallow water and swells crashing on the shore can prevent you getting in close where the fish are.
But today, we've got no boat.
But that's no worries, because we can access it in the Hilux.
I mean, on an isolated beach like this, it just screams potential. There's no one else here, well, except my mates, a few locals up here that have reserved the good spot. That's obviously where the fish are. We're going to be doing every single kind of beach fishing you can imagine, and one of them you could never imagine. It is pretty unique.
When are we firing the cannon?
That was going to be a surprise. But I guess we're going to be firing a cannon.
Oh, mate, I've seen it strapped to the back. And to be honest, it's one of the reasons I'm on this trip.
Right, here we go, here's the boys right here.
I don't know what to do with the street.
Up, isn't it?
Morning, boysies. Yeah, mate, did a piece of cake. Well, well, well. Yeah, he's been getting on all right?
Yeah.
This tide that's running out of this creek here, is that wrapping around this way?
Yeah, you can see all the water coming around underneath here. The snapper should be all hanging around here with all the
rubbish,
worms, and bits and pieces coming off it.
Yo, beauty. Right. Oh well, we'll get the contacty set up, and as the tide comes in, we can just creep forward a bit, eh?
Yeah.
Beauty. Beauty. You got all that?
I just love standing in the background looking like I actually know what I'm doing. Pretending you're paying attention, having no idea. Why the hell are snappers sitting there in behind this? I mean, I know what you said, but why?
Oh, just because it's easy food, you know. Any fish, it's all about food for them, you know.
So anything that the river's disturbing stuff.
Yeah, well, it's dragging all the grubs and stuff down, okay. And it's, as it's coming out, they'll just be sitting there, almost like a trout in the stream sort of setup. And it also is dragging out the sand, which exposes the shellfish a little bit more for them.
Yeah.
Just tell me when I can stop, because I'm starting to make things
well,
up now.
Well, it's so frustrating, you know. You don't notice. See, I'd be throwing my line in here because it's not quite as disturbed.
Yeah, no worries. Just give us a shout, I can feed you
just
a few
let me
lines.
Shoot the cannon.
Yeah, you can get the fire the cannon.
Tight to the old rail blazers, locked in, solid.
We want to get that bad boy out.
Hey, can I do anything to help? That tube's the cannon, isn't it?
That is the.
Do you want me to get that off?
That can stay there for now.
Really?
Oh yeah, we'll get the contact here.
Couple of practice shots.
One thing at a time. One thing at a time. Here you go, Macca. Pass it out, right? That's your machine right there.
Perfect. The good thing about this is you whack 25. Apparently the legal number of hooks. Whack it on, send her out, sit there, have a couple of cleansing ales, and then wine and dinner. It's my kind of fishing.
So we're bunging our battery in there, fit snugly, and then we plug her in, power it up. That should give us, well there you go, 25 minutes of running time for the motor. And this is a GPS model, so if we just point it to where we want it to go, the GPS will fix itself on a position, and it'll run it that way, no matter what the wind and current's doing. And one trick for young players is just to make sure that this is done up properly. We could flash back to some footage of where I didn't do it up properly and it sank. And we had cameras mounted on it when it sank.
Getting real heavy, eh?
It is getting heavy. It hasn't been out there that long, I wonder if it sunk, mate.
Oh, no.
On this very beach. On this very beach. Okay, make sure that lid's on tight. Oh, helicam's up. Sweet. Let's launch this bad boy then, eh? Start motor. Okay, we're going. Oh, yeah. Right, we're gonna start getting some traces on, I guess, eh?
Now this is the risky bit, isn't it?
Yeah, if you can start unclipping them, yep, that'd be awesome, Macca, thank you. So the seahorse there has got tray now we've pre-baited. We've got some koi carp bait that Kieran's brought along, and we've got some octopus, which John caught. Oki's great bait off the beach. And so far, this is going like clockwork. And this is exactly how the system that seahorse design works. So yeah, I'll go this one. We're barely not too far down on the end.
Last, mate.
Beautiful. And a sinker. One of those there. And we just clip a sinker on at the end just to keep it all on the deck. Because that's what the fish should be doing here, you know, out on the sand, should be foraging around, looking for the shellfish and stuff, looking for crabs, little crustaceans that live in the sand, and snake eels. On this beach in particular, they eat a lot of snake eels. I've said enough, we just need some fish.
Is that 25 hooks in about 4 minutes? Yeah. Not even that. Where's she going? Look at that, perfect dangling.
I'm not sure how we'll start off, but that moon there,
yeah.
As soon as that hits the horizon and disappears, you're going to start catching fish.
Why is that?
I don't know, it's just something I've noticed over the years. When that moon, when you've got the moon in the sky during the day, when it hits the horizon, I mean, the moon affects water, the fish live in water. It does something mysterious, but that's when they start biting, when the moon hits the horizon. Oh, there we go.
There's some serious fish out here.
You can't keep up. You need more hands, boy.
Oh, this is brilliant. This is everything a bloke wants, isn't it? Like guns, fishing, food.
Yeah, boy! Now here's our rig, which is very much a basic surf casting rig. We've got the sand gripper sinker. So that just before you cast, you want to make sure that these little wire jobs are bent down and locked in. So when that casts out, I'll show you. It goes into the sand and it grips, okay, so it holds in position.
And we've got a little float on that hook there.
Yep.
So your bait floats up off the sand and it stops the crabs eating it.
What sort of bait then?
You choose, Macca. Whatever you think. I know it's a kid in the candy store.
Can you put a combo on?
You can put a combo on if you can't decide. Dang, this combo right here. The Oki koi carp combo.
Yeah.
Oh, these are both tough baits. So you don't want to be wrapping it through and sort of doing a whole work of art. From the flesh side, or the skinniest part of the bait, from the flesh side through the skin side. Like so. And with your bit of Oki, just on the end there, through once. Just to help it sort of hold together, you get this little bait thread from hunting and fishing. This is just sort of insurance that the old buddy, that isn't going to fly off, or a little fish isn't going to come along and nibble it, and you're going to lose your bait before you've even begun. See, now that's all snug, that's not going anywhere.
Yeah, gotcha.
And you're ready to go. Way you go, she's all yours, big fella.
Thanks, bud. So if we give it to
you, those big levers working.
Likely it's gonna break.
Don't blow, it'll only be on film forever. Oh, there you go. Lovely little lob. Rightio then, Macca. Here we go, you just hang on to that.
On a cold winter's day, this will warm you right to the core. Getting quite excited. What sort of PSI are we going to? 200?
Oh, no, no, we won't. We're not going to max it out. We'll work our way up. Pressuring it up.
So we're covering all bases pretty much, aren't we? We've got the Kentucky, we've got, you know, four rods in the water, and now we've got the cannon going right out the back. Brilliant.
Yep, just close that valve, yeah. Sweet. Now what I've got going on here is the old mould, missile-shaped mould here. Oh, I've got a bait, big bait on there.
Yep.
tied onto my hook, sinker, trace, everything. I've got the swivel just sticking out the top, and it's been frozen and burly. Just got to sort of lever her out. You want to hold onto that big fella? Jesus Christ. Here we go.
Oh, look at that.
We just got to be careful not to crack it now. Stoke the cannon.
Oh, this is brilliant. This is everything a bloke wants, isn't it? Like guns, fishing.
I've never done it like this before, but I might actually get you to hold the rod while it's firing. You just have to hold it very steadily. Just spraying a bit of lube on here, because for the first cast, it's coming off at such velocity that the line will snap. Okay, Macca, you need to be pointing that in exactly the right angle.
Yeah.
And don't get a fright and do anything like that when it goes off.
Right.
Okay, so just pull the red pin out with one hand and dump that as fast as you can. And 3, 2, 1, go. Give it heat.
Yeah, boy!
Boom!
Hey. Awesome. Oh, that's good. That is good. Jeez, it gets some distance, doesn't it?
That was worth price of admission alone, eh?
Mate, those seagulls are game.
Yeah. Really? Okay, yeah, we'll just wind it, we'll just wind that tight and we'll pop it in the rod holder on the old back of the old Lux there.
Nice cast.
Well done, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot better than the first.
Thanks.
Is he eating them? Is he them? Yeah. Yep. Yep. Yeah, yeah, Captain, you pull the fish in. Here we go, mate. Welcome to the far north. This is how we roll.
Just don't drop it.
No, no pressure. There's only like about 7 cameras poised on you at the moment.
Feel quite weighty, Craig?
Yeah, there's a couple of flips here, right?
Yeah, good.
Got a weight there. Way to wind,
isn't it? It's a long way to wind, isn't it? It went out a long way, you see.
Whenever you grab a meal, mate, the fish goes on.
Yeah, that's it. Macca cracks the old meal, mates, and voila. Whammo. They're the new veggie ones.
What?
Got they must be a bit further out, eh?
Well, you got time to have lunch before I get it in.
Mm. Well, I wonder a few
tugs on this as well, I reckon.
I wonder with our contiki set didn't go that far. We'd be in the same zone as we would. You know,
about the start of the hooks.
This here would have been the start of the hooks.
Pretty close to it, yeah.
No pressure, but he hasn't got it in yet.
Oh, I know. Yeah, just keep your weight on, mate. Keep your weight on, keep it moving forward. Oh, one to the blaster caster.
Mm. Oh, jeez. Hey. Don't blow it, mate. Don't blow it.
Don't blow it now.
Bring it in on that wave.
Oh, nice snapper.
Walk back to the wave, bro.
Keep coming back, keep coming. Ahoy, eh?
Beautiful.
Yeah!
That's it! Yeah. That's a blaster caster, it's a nice pinky, isn't it?
That's a beautiful snapper.
Let's see those pop up.
Hey! Oh, don't you love it when you start like this? Just takes the pressure off. Of course, I knew that we were going to, as I was saying, Macca, and look around, can you see the moon? Just spin around and get that camera shot for us. Look out the way, please, guys. Spin around there. Folks, can we see that moon? No, it's gone. So as soon as that moon goes, mate, we're going to get a bite, and that's what happened.
I actually was a bit nervous that you might, under that sort of pressure, not quite bring it in, but you've landed it.
There you go.
Up.
That's a beauty.
It's a cracker, isn't it? How heavy is that, you reckon?
Oh, I reckon that'll be about 4 kilo.
That's got to be close to the biggest snapper I've ever caught.
The cannon did it.
Yeah, boy!
300-400 yards off. Look at what we've got. Good 10-pound snapper. Biggest snapper I've ever seen, to be honest. Biggest one I've ever been near that's been caught, been pulled in my presence. Usually really bad luck when it comes to fishing.
You can claim it, Macca.
Well, I mean, the next one that comes in will be mine. I'm definitely firing this next. Bang! Blaster caster one. I reckon we've got a few on the Contiki out there, but nothing caught thus far, close to shore. They're out deep.
Yeah, that's it. Just bend it slightly forward. So good. Yeah, there you go. Well, it's time to pull the old contiki in. Now, rather than using up the battery on my Seahorse winch there, we've wired a plug. We've got a waterproof accessory plug in the back of the old Hilux here, so we can just plug that fella in, flick her on, and we're pulling in our line, or pulling our fish, if we're being optimistic. first hook, mate, and we got him. Oh, one on each hook. Oh no, we might have a full string of the buggers here. We might be time to go home, boys. Start unclipping those fish, boys.
Look at the size of the buggers too, mate.
Oh, there's one on every bloody hook so far. Okay, boys, you've seen the routine, eh? Get those hooks out, those clips back onto the board. The fellas will show you how to put them onto the board, get the hook out, spike them and get them on ice. There's a nice snapper too there, boys. Oh, hey. Oh, look, everyone's come out of the woodwork now. We've got a whole chain gang of everyone. Now everyone's seen the snapper flicking in the surf.
Well, oh, look at that. Here he is. You beauty.
Look at the size of that.
Big cow head.
Look at that, eh?
Hey! It's a beauty, eh?
Oh. Any bigger than that and we'll start letting them go, eh, fellas? But these are just beautiful eaters. Look at them, they just keep on coming.
That'd be the biggest snapper I've ever got. And look at it, this one here could eat it.
We've got a real production line going, haven't we? Oh, look, here goes another one.
Too.
Oh, there we go.
Too big for the roots.
That one's taking two baits. Oh, well, they're all beautiful fish too. There's no pustas, eh?
Oh yeah,
you might be lucky if you get two out of 25 hooks. We've got 10, and this is the smallest guy here. Chubby old 5-pounder. It's almost worth throwing back by the state of the others.
Yeah. Look at that. There's another one coming. You can't keep up. You need more hands, boy.
Watch this guy, he's gonna fall off first. Oh, he's on the burly bag.
Yeah.
He was on the burly bag.
Oh, he's just falling off. He was stuck on the burly bag.
Yeah, mate.
Is this even good by your standards?
No, that's pretty good.
It's always good, mate, when you get some beautiful snappers like these guys. Look at, they're just stunning. Oh, of course there is, mate. Yeah, we can't keep up, the boys can't keep up.
Beautiful condition fish, man. Fat winter fish, you can't beat it.
I mean, some of these guys that are really kicking well that haven't been on the line for a long time, I think we might just put them back. Now these fish here, of course, are well legal, but they've only just hopped on the line. You can see great colour in him. His eyes are still really clear. He's going to swim away, no worries. As is his buddy here, so. Way you go, buddy. Way you go, boys. Way you go. Here he goes, look at this. He's gone back to his home. Are you going to be able to close that lid?
Full load of snapper.
Oh, jeez.
Can't quite close it, eh?
Can't quite close it.
Yes, we can.
Well, well, there you go, fellas. One set with the Contiki, and I think it's time to put the Contiki away.
It's just gone 10 in the morning, and we've done our fishing for the day. Certainly need a bin, chock-a-block, one Contiki.
I mean, there's no argument there. We've got enough feed for us and a few of the locals and a few of the locals' mates, and then some.
Have you ever seen fishing like that?
Never. No, not off the beach. That's impressive, eh?
How's that? Right. Yeah, these snapper are in fantastic nick. But of course, we've got to make sure that we get every last scrap out of them. Well, I mean, a snapper like this would easily feed the three of us. Easily.
Yeah.
If we eat the whole lot, you know. I mean, there's a lot in the fillets, of course.
Well, you boil the head up and make a nice soup.
Yeah, you tried the fish heads before?
Yeah, I've got a lady who works across the road who says if you ever get a snapper, bring it in. She makes the best seafood chowder in Auckland.
Brilliant. Yeah, I mean, I would much sooner eat the head than the fillets.
Yeah.
But I've given up convincing people that that's the case, so I just say to people, look, and that's what we'll do with these.
Yep.
Freefishheads.co.nz, dial it up and it'll tell us the nearest person will come and get them from us.
Perfect.
Yep, oh, but I'll be keeping these two biggies for myself. One of your tricks with filleting, Macca, is like a lot of people will come down and they'll crunch through that gut cavity. That's all the guts inside there.
Yeah.
But if you let your knife come up and over those ribs,
right,
you can take that fillet off and you don't have to wash it. Not even in seawater, you shouldn't. It's a bit of a misnomer, they say, oh, as long as you wash your fillets in salt water, it's okay. There's no need to wash that, because there's no slime, there's one little scale there. If I just lay that down, and I skin it there and leave it on its skin, it's never touched the bait board, nothing.
you put it in water and that's what creates all the juice. Put it in the fridge, bacteria, and that's where you get the fishy smell.
Yep.
Like that, there.
How long does a fillet last?
If that fillet there, if I was to pat that dry with a paper towel, chuck it in the fridge,
yep,
in a nice sealed container, I'd get a week comfortably. If I was to wash it, 2 days max, and it's
so
going to be stinky.
So if you go to the supermarket and you can smell the fish.
Yeah, it's actually the slime you can smell.
Yeah.
It's the slime, the bacteria growing in the slime. And the slime's created by getting the fillet wet. Now I'll just finish this fillet off, eh? Just for demonstration's sake, because not everybody wants to sit through this, and we'll just use Magic ETV to get on. You don't want a lip on anything when you're skinning, so you get the old fillet down to the skin. And just, you hold your knife pretty well still and you pull your fillet towards the skin. And the trick is I just leave that on, because if your board's dirty and it's got fish slime on it, see, if you feel that board, it's slimy, that's that slime, yeah, that'll make your fish go rotten. But if you leave it sitting on the skin that way, there's a center line of bones, take it out. That's full of bone, but we don't throw that away. We treat that the same way as our fish head. That goes in the same broth, or you can smoke them up. The old, some of the old folks call them harmonicas, because they cook them up and they... Well, we've got a few more of these to chop our way through, and these guys, having seen how it's done, are going to help me, because tomorrow, something else. Land baits fishing a completely different style.
Mate, I'm more worried about dinner tonight.
We'll get to dinner tonight.
Good.
And we'll show these guys the fishing tomorrow. I'm going to chuck a few there. Watch what happens to that little handful.
Yeah, boy.
Oh, big snapper. Big snapper, bro.
It's feeling snappery. It's feeling snappery. Mac is on. That's a real goodie, mate. That's a real goodie. That could be our 20.
Ooh, mate, you're not gonna make that.
There we go. Hey! There we go.
Here we're going to leg it. We've got a bit of gear to lug in, but that's all right. Is it about this stage that I start amping up? You know, we can see all the swells coming in, all the wash, and just the potential of a bit of coastline like this. And it's a screaming snapper. Although, while that swell's good for stirring everything up and getting them feeding, it might just be a wee bit much. So we'll go and have a look. We have to err on the side of caution. If it's too dangerous, we won't fish, but we might just have to hang back and take it easy for the first little while, fellas. You right with that last? Oh, you alright? Just watch that slippery rock.
So if we get onto them here, what sort of size are we talking?
Over the magical 20 here.
Over 20 pounds?
Over the magical 20. And but in these conditions, mate, if we land one of those,
yeah,
it would be akin to landing a 35 pounder out of a boat.
Jeez, now conditions. We're talking.
So mate, in terms of how hard we're going to have to work for it. But don't get excited when you do see them come up. Listen to me, we'll try and wash them into a gut. I've got the crampons and the wetsuit, so I'll go down and grab it.
Grab it.
Bear hug them all.
Right, brilliant.
Okay.
I like it a lot.
And just and everybody keep an eye forward on the ocean as well. Don't turn your back and just watching out for each other, especially these guys with the cameras. Okay, right.
Burley's in the water, hooks are going on, bait will be there after, then 20 pounders.
Okay, a pilchard, where's your hook? Here is the rig, fellas. So pull one gill plate off, like so, just to expose. Just about a finger space back from the where you've ripped the gill plate off.
Yeah.
Go through again. And then this time you want to roll the hook around so it comes under the other gill plate. You'll roll it around and it'll poke out of that gill plate you ripped off.
Oh yeah, I got you.
And you see, then you just get your line, you do a half hitch around the tail. And what happens is all your gill plates letting out all that oil, they always eat head first. When they hit head first, oomfa. Okay? Don't get too close, eh? To the water.
That's a brilliant bloody tip, that.
Looks good.
I'm going to jump out on this rock on the end here, but be careful if you're here, eh? You won't need to cast far, so it's just a little underhand lob. Just a little about there. Close your bail arm and turn your bait runner on straight away, okay? So the bait runner lever goes down.
Yeah.
They'll grab it.
Shall
they'll
I
whiz off.
Just cast from here, mate?
Yeah, or? Just yep. Lob it just down in here.
Yeah. How come you're on the high point there, buddy?
Yeah, let it run with it. Yeah, let it run, let it run. Hit him, hit him, hit him. Wind and hit him. Oh, double hookup, boys. Double hookup. That's a kahawai.
Oh, Jesus. There we go.
You're tangling me up now as well. What are you doing?
Well, I'm trying to get them.
You want to keep that?
If any are hook deep and bleeding, like Macca's ones, a bit of blood, roll the hook out of your one, chuck them back, we don't need them. Any of them that are bleeding, we'll keep for fresh baits. Bit more like it, boysies.
What do you got there, boy?
Nah, it's feeling snappery, it's feeling snappery. Oh yeah, look at that, boys! Right down there. Okay, I'm gonna try and beach it just down there. Okay, keep an eye on those waves. I might pass you the rod in a sec, Macca. Pass right, you mate. My one, maybe.
Got him, got him.
Oh, there shit. He is. It's a goodie.
It's a goodie,
a lot
mate.
Harder to get them out of here than it is on the sand. Just wanna hold that rod for please, mate. Right. Just don't let him get his head down. Yeah, my boys. Hey. Hey, that's how we get the
well
snapper
done,
out of
brother.
The... Oh, yeah, hit him, Macca, hit him, hit him. That could be the one, boy, you stay with him. Now I better sort this one out. Macca's, oh, that's a real goodie, mate. That's a real goodie, that could be our 20. Keep him moving. There's dinner.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's only a little. No, yeah, you're high. There you go, boys. See ya. You earn them.
Mate, we're in.
You earn them heaps more off the rocks, eh?
Yeah,
you're off the beach.
Course, eh? Yeah, boy.
Now you can see, like, off the rocks, it's not like off the sand where you can let them run. It's gnarly, there's sharp rocks. You just got to work these hard fighting snapper away from the rocks. Otherwise, ping.
Relax.
These first couple will do us for dinner. And then I think we might target that big old one and see if we can get that magical 20 pounder out of here.
Oh, snapped off. I hooked one, but snapped me off on the rocks.
We're on a land-based fishing mission in the far north. And so far, we've aced the beach fishing with a good haul of snapper on our Seahorse Contiki and Sandblaster cast.
That's how we do it. That's how we roll.
Now we're fishing from the rocks, which is my favourite form of land-based fishing. Both yeah, Mark boy. And I have caught a couple of nice snapper, but our competition winner Craig has been a bit unlucky. The conditions aren't ideal, so when the swell rises, we retreat to higher ground to sit it out for a while. And while we're waiting for the swell to drop, let's take a look at what this spot looked like when we discovered it a couple of months ago when we had just an hour before dark on a calm winter's evening when we encountered the snapper feeding right in close to the rocks.
Now the first thing that I like to do when I get to a spot, particularly in instances like this when I don't have a lot of time, is get the burley in the water. That way the old burley can start working while I'm spending the time to rig up my lines and get some baits ready. Now a good spot for your burley is just right in close somewhere where there's a little bit of wash, just a little bit of action to get it working. And I've got two burley bombs in there now. One, I've pretty much gutted, slashed it open. Because I've not got a lot of time, I really want a fast flow. The other, just a few holes, which is gonna take a little bit longer to drain out. And in winter time, that is just like ringing the dinner bell for Mr. Snapper. Great looking ledge. Now, I've not brought a whole lot of bait with me, partly because I didn't even know if I was gonna go fishing today, and if I did, I wasn't gonna have much time. But also, whenever you've got a bit of a walk, I certainly prefer to carry more weight in burley than in bait, because after all, burley is gonna bring in other bait fish that you can catch and use for fresh bait, which is always gonna be better. I've just got a bit of old frozen tuna that I found in my freezer here. And again, even before I rig up some baits, or even rig up a line, I'm gonna cube some of this up and chuck some chunks out to enhance that burley trail. Because after all, if you can't get the fish around, you're not gonna catch anything at all. I'm just sort of spreading these chunks in and around this gut. And I don't like to make them too big, because of course, you don't want a snapper back there getting enough of a feed that he doesn't have to come out from undercover. I just like to spread them around. And one of the great things about fishing off the rocks is you'll often get to see snapper swimming right in at your feet. As far as snapper fishing goes, it doesn't really get better than that. Now chuck a few there. Watch what happens to that little handful. Kahawai. So that gives me the confidence now that I can really pump the burley, use this tuna for burley, and catch the kahawai for fresh snapper bait. Or, in fact, eat the kahawai. They're good eating in their own right. Oh, snapper. Here you go, there's my point. We didn't need to carry in a whole lot of bait. We haven't even got a hook out of my pack yet, and already there's snapper swimming around here. Not a bad little excursion, I haven't even started fishing yet. Love finding new terrain like this. Lemon hoers, eh? Incredible, look at that. Look at that. Our burley and chunks have done the trick, and we've got plenty of snapper swimming around the rocks in plain sight. In winter, it's harder for the snapper to find food. Yeah. So when they smell an easy meal, like the normally shy snapper will become more bold and come out in the open to get a feed. So while it's tempting to get a bait into the water right now, the longer we burley, the more snapper will show up. And the big ones will eventually come to the surface also. The trouble is, when the time comes to drop a bait, it can be hard to hook the one you want.
Oh, big snapper. Big snapper, bro. There's a beauty. Big snapper's just turned up there.
There's the nice one again. I was going to cast it. Hopefully he'll get it before those other ones will. Stay on that bait, Dave.
No, not the kahawai. No, no, not you.
No, those kahawai are coming straight in on it. There is that. There's a little snapper.
Yeah, little one got it.
It's a pen, you know, but nothing like the blooming one that was, that was hanging around. Look at that. I mean, that's not a bad snapper, really, when you consider that I've just watched it eat my bait, and it's about half the size of its mate. That was, but that'll be coming home with me. Thank you very much. Marara.
Yeah.
It's probably too dark for that camera now.
Yeah.
So you might as well grab this other rod and fish. Away from the burley, this whole bay must be full of them. Ooh. It's not a bad one.
Take it. Yep. Getting nibbles.
I didn't hear it run off.
No, I just took it off. It's still there.
Let, well, let it eat it. You've got to let it eat it.
Eat it!
Get off!
Oh, yeah. Wind it tight and hook the fish, like so. Like so example. There's another snapper out there, away from the burley. This whole bay must be full of them. Here we go, he's got my bait. Little sod. Turn the handle, wind the handle then. Ah, you cooked it, have you?
No, yeah,
you
got it.
What the?
Oh!
I think every snapper in the bay heard about that though.
Damn it. Hook.
That was a nice one too,
Should
eh?
It was too.
Probably the best one all day.
Oh, another bait on.
It was the best one all day. Oh, actually, it's the big one. Big snapper. He's gone straight for this gnarly bit. What was wrong with him staying over there on the ledge where it was? There he is, nice snapper.
Oh yeah. Where we gonna wash him up in that gut over there, Marita?
Go down to that gut. Just wait, just grab the tray and beat him towards you. That's it. Now grab him by the tail or something. Watch, there's two hooks, so don't hit yourself. Grab him by the tail. Oh, pull your... Ah, no! Fill your boots up with water at the same time. Are you alright?
Yeah. No, it's not in my jeans.
Oh, shit, I thought it was in your leg. Just be careful so it doesn't end up in your leg. Oh, just be careful.
Hooked through your jeans. That is a nice snapper.
Okay.
Beauty.
You've done yourself a mischief, actually. You're probably going to be easier to unhook the snapper than it is on you. Oh, okay. Oh. Snapper's unhooked, but Marlott is still hooked. I'm going to slip that into the water. It might be just about time for us to go just as these big ones are coming on, but a little bit of reconnaissance after work mission, and I think we'll be back. But one last thing to do, which is to let this guy go and unhook Marlott. Nice sort of size breeding fish. Oh, and he powers away. And as my headlamp hits the burley trail, there's a whole lot more bigger fish that have turned up here as well. Oh, I just love it, man, finding new spots.
Well, we know that this spot holds plenty of snapper. And now that the swell settled down, we can give our mate Craig one last shot at getting a snapper off the rocks.
Just re-rigging for the, I think it's the third or fourth time. The rocks are pretty ruthless around here when you hook up. I hooked a goodie that last one, I think, and it sucked me into those rocks and pinged me straight off. Do a big one, buddy. And hopefully this bait sticks. Nice.
Hey, what are you doing wrong?
Beauty of using these nice big 9-barrow hooks is these smaller, still respectable snapper, but slightly smaller, always hooked in the corner of the mouth. And I can carefully let this guy go because we've got enough for a feed. And away he goes. There he goes. Yoldy.
The old bait's getting a bit worn out. But it's my last bait, so I'll throw it out again.
The winner of the competition striking a forlorn figure. Time's been called about 20 minutes ago, but he's still out there. He's still battling away. He's only caught bait fish. Bait fish.
Get a gaff, get a net. Quick, net it. Oh, he's got a snapper. He's done it. He's done it. Oh, you don't understand how happy he's going to be. He's really been quite a forlorn figure down there. He's done it. Oh, dear. I mean, the ultimate indignity. He's caught his first snapper, but it's only a 27. I think they've got to be 30 now. Is it a keeper?
Yeah, it's legal, but not legal here, bro.
Oh, hey, whoa! Oh.
Oh, did you want him?
That would have made the score 1-1.
Never happened then. The conditions have hardly been ideal, but I think we've done pretty well to get a couple of snapper, and well, now that the tide's turned, it's just a little bit dicey. We're going to have to leave those big old snapper biting, and the real big ones are going to have to wait till next time, fellas. And we'll err on the side of caution because we've got a wee cook-up, a little wee banquet to get to. Might involve some fresh fish.
Yes!
Oh, there we go. Fresh bread rolls there. And we've even got some lettuce.
Well, I'm sure this fish is going to live up to expectations. I don't want to carry on with the cooking too much because I don't want to put Al Brown out of a job.
Mate, you're no chef. I'll tell you what, you can catch fish, but look at that.
Hey.
This is meant to be our final hurrah, and he butchers the dinner.
That is going to be fantastic. That's going to be fantastic. Right, I've heard enough of this. Wrap your chops around that. I think this says it all.
A couple of great spots. No complaints from me.
Pretty special up north here.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
Appreciate you having us.
No worries, mate. Yeah, no worries.
Well, the only thing I would change is probably your fishing. Aside from that, everything's gone swimmingly.
It was a team effort.
Cheers.
A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.